Indonesia, the world's fourth most populated country in the world and a major producer of agricultural products. However, do you know that Indonesia is becoming a country that contributes to the ASEAN annual series of transboundary haze pollution because of the illegal agricultural fire? Stay tuned everyone, because in this video, we will look into the commitments made by the Republic of Indonesia in tackling this issue. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and hi IB to the respected panelists. In this video, we are going to present our research topic entitled Malaysian Awareness towards the commitment by the Republic of Indonesia in responding to transboundary haze pollution. Throughout this research, we have been supervised by our dear supervisor, Madam Nur Suhaiza binti Mohammad Khalid. Before we go into a deeper explanation, allow me to introduce myself. Hi everyone, this is Mohammad Zulhafiy bin Bahari, student ID 2018-292. I'm together with my research partner, Nur Farhana binti Mohammad Abbas, to present our research study. We are from AM2286H and the final year students of Bachelor in Administrative Science UiTM Seremban. Here are our presentation overview.
Let us look into the first chapter, which is Introduction.
As for the introduction, Gaffer in 2012 has defined awareness as the condition of people that being conscious or knowledgeable on certain matters. Meanwhile, the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development in 2013 has described transboundary pollution as a condition where the originated pollution that happens in one country disperses and spreads until it crosses border of another country, whether through air or water as the pathway of the disperse, which will cause damage to the environment to another neighboring country. With that, this study will further discuss the level of Malaysian awareness towards the commitments made by the government of the Republic of Indonesia in responding to transboundary haze pollution. Moving on to the research background, Netherson in 2020 defined population as the mixture of any other substances in the state of solid, liquid and gas form, in the state of heat, sound and radioactivity to the environment. Greenpeace Southeast Asia 2019 mentioned that during the dry season, which mainly occurs in July until October, the peak smoke haze from Kalimantan and Sumatra will disperse towards neighboring countries such as Singapore, Malaysia, and to a lesser extent, Southern Thailand. There are several factors that cause the transboundary haze pollution in Southeast Asia that can be identified. The first factor is agricultural activity. Devi 2014 stated that agriculture industry is one of the main contribution resulting from Indonesian fires. The next factor is the usage of slash and burn techniques by Indonesian farmers. Ki Jin Tan in 1999 stated that slash and burn techniques are the most popular practices for clearing the land or forest in Indonesia as the activities were cheap and easy to do. In this study, researchers have identified several major problems in the occurrence of ASEAN annual series of haze pollution. Firstly, there was an ineffectiveness, which is the delay of the Indonesian government to ratify the regional haze treaty called ASEAN Agreement on Transboundary Haze Pollution in handling the transboundary haze pollution in Southeast Asia. As a result, the capacity of the Indonesian government to withstand more robust regional initiative internationally was reduced because they faced considerable pressure, according to Hurley and Lee in 2020. Singapore and Malaysia are highly affected countries that have put the game of blame on Indonesia in effective solution to address this issue. Hillman in 2015 stated that Indonesia does have regulation against unauthorized burning, but this legislation is ineffective because of inadequate compliance and incentive misalignment. This haze pollution has become a major problem as it brings huge impact. Firstly, in Malaysia, nearly 2,500 schools, including nearly 300 in the smog-hit capital of Kuala Lumpur, were forced to suspend over rising health hazard due to uncontrollable blazing danger of the island of Sumatra and Borneo, as according to Al Jazeera in 2019. The next impact can be referred to a study by Soriat Matja in 2019, whereby at least two people, including one children, are dead from the deepening haze pollution in South Sumatra, and five NGOs has accused Indonesian government of severe violation of human rights for their failure to monitor Sumatra and Kalimantan fires. In this study, researchers have constructed three main questions. Firstly, what is the level of knowledge of Malaysian awareness towards the commitments by the Indonesian government in responding to transboundary haze pollution? Secondly, what is the relationship between knowledge, attitudes, and perception towards the commitments by the Indonesian government in responding to transboundary haze pollution? Lastly, what are the main factors that contribute to the level of Malaysian awareness toward the commitments by the Indonesian government in responding to haze pollution? With all of the research questions that have mentioned earlier, we have constructed three research objectives. However, the primary objective of this study is to identify the Malaysian awareness of transboundary haze pollution that happened in Southeast Asia annually with the guidance of the Indonesian commitments. Therefore, we can analyze the three main objectives of this study, which can be looked into the slides.
Chapter to Literature Review and Conceptual Framework.
For the first literature review in this study is the concept of international environmental law. We can refer to the concept from two different perspectives, which are from the United Nations and ASEAN perspective. United Nations concept of international environmental law has highlighted the state responsibility principle. Hamid and Sin 2017 stated that primacy of economic development, that is to say the ability of states to establish and attain their economic objective, seems to be a significant barrier to the conservation of the environment. To clarify, each state has their own responsibilities in maintaining its national interests, such as improving the economic growth that will provide a gap for them to conserve the environment. In addition, ASEAN has adopted the principle of quiet diplomacy, which can also provide a gap in conserving the regional environment. Tay in 1998 mentioned that the ASEAN's principle of non-interference demonstrates that no state has the power to tell a different nation how to regulate its internal affairs, particularly when it happens across region when environmental problems such as transboundary haze pollution are faced with difficulties. The second literature review is the technique of slash and burn. Indonesian farmers are using this technique is in general because it can save costs. Britannica in 2019 stated that the local companies and farmers in Indonesia from the agriculture and harvesting industry, such as palm oil, will take part in SMB operation for their farms in September annually, which will generate significant transboundary haze pollution problems, not just in Indonesia, but also in neighboring states such as Malaysia and Singapore. Young in 2019 stated that fires that happened in Indonesia were reportedly sparked by the use of SNB method by farmers to clear the environmental rich soil, which can be seen as the same activity that led to uncontrollable fires in Brazilian Amazon. The third literature review is the knowledge of the international agreement. Skrikant 2006 described that an individual without knowledge is when they do not understand something because they cannot properly analyze or describe it. There are two international agreements that has been identified, which are firstly Paris Agreement and secondly AATHP. Paris Agreement is the first ever universal legally binding global consensus on climate change that implemented at Paris Climate Change Conference in December 2015. Paris Agreement was ratified by ASEAN member states in December 2015 to reduce annual pollution from 20% to 65% by 2030. However, AATHP demand coordination on the production and execution of initiatives aimed at avoiding and controlling transboundary haze emission by land sources and illegal logging, development monitoring, early warning system assessment, knowledge and technology exchanges, and provision of mutual assistance. Moving on to the fourth literature review, which is attitude towards Indonesian legislation. Igli and Chaike 1993 define attitude as a psychological tendency that is expressed in an evaluation of a particular entity with some kind of favor of disadvantage. Indonesian government has established two laws that aim to conserve the environment and reduce haze pollution. The first one is the Indonesian Environmental Protection Law No. 23/1997, which criminalizes the deliberate performance of environmental contamination acts facing a maximum jail sentence of 10 years or maximum fine of Indonesian rupiah 500 million. The second law is Environmental Protection and Management Act No. 32 that was established in 2009 and announced as a full package of provision covering nearly all elements of modern environmental law, including protecting all environmental aspects in Indonesia, according to UN 2017. The last literature review is the perception of Indonesian commitments. Perception is derived from Latin terms perceptio and percipio, which is a mechanism of consciousness or understanding sensory input, referring to philosophy, psychology, and cognitive sciences. The Peatland Restoration Agency PRA has taken real action to compel forest fire elimination in Indonesia, such as ordering the regeneration of 95,000 hectares of degraded peatland by Bumi Mekar Hijau and prohibiting from examining a timber concession owned by PT Andalan Pulp and Paper in Riau. Moving on to the next part, which is conceptual framework. In this research study, the dependent variable that has been identified is the level of Malaysian awareness. This DV has highly dependent and associated with three independent variables, which are the knowledge on international agreement, attitude on Indonesian legislation, and also perception towards Indonesian commitments.
Hi, assalamualaikum and a very good morning, I bid to all the panelists. I am now Farhana, the second presenter of the research. So let's move on to the next content, which is the hypothesis of the study. The study consists of three different hypotheses, which is hypothesis 1, there is a significant relationship between the knowledge on the Indonesian commitment and the level of Malaysian awareness in responding to transboundary haze pollution. Next, there is a significant relationship between the attitude on the Indonesian commitment and the level of Malaysian awareness in responding to transboundary haze pollution. And lastly, there is a significant relationship between the perceptions of the Indonesian commitment and the level of Malaysian awareness in responding to transboundary haze pollution.
Let us proceed with Chapter 3, which is the research methodology.
Next, I will briefly introduce the methodology used in the study. In this study, we will be using a cross-sectional research design that involves a collection of data among students in majoring in international relations in UNIMAS, UUM, UNISA, and UMS. We contact the student through formal emails and letter distribute to them so that they can distribute the questionnaire to other respondents. Next, by referring to the Kroger-Morgan table, the sample size of our respondent would be 260 students as the populations of students in 5 different universities measuring in international relations is 785 students. Next, the sampling technique used would be the simple random sampling, which allow an equal chances of being selected in the sample. In this study also, the statistical analytic used and proposed would be the descriptive analysis toward the dependent variable, Pearson correlation and multiple regression were conducted on the independent variable.
Next chapter is Chapter 4, which is the finding and analysis.
Moving on to the next content, that is the demographic profile of the respondent. A brief information for the demographic profile in this study, the female would be contributing more than male at 53% of the respondent. For the age, the respondent among the 18 and 22 years old contribute more than the other, also at 53%. Next, the Malay respondent dominated the study as it contributes 90.4% of the data. In terms of the university, the student in University of Malaya, UM, contributed the most at 40%. And lastly, the resident from urban area contributes more to the data at 47%. Let's moving on to the next presentation, which is the hypothesis testing. To check the hypothesis mentioned earlier, we used the descriptive analysis to determine the level of Malaysian awareness towards the commitment by the Indonesian government in responding to transboundary haze pollution. Next, we used Pearson correlation to study the relationship between the knowledge, the attitude, and the level of perceptions on the commitment by the Indonesian government in responding to transboundary haze pollution. Lastly, we also used the multiple regression to determine and identify the main factor that contributes to the level of awareness among the Malaysian.
The last chapter is Chapter 5, which is the conclusion.
Finally, we come to the most crucial part of the presentation, which is the discussions of the finding. after the testing, we finally complete and answered the three research questions mentioned in the study. Based on the descriptive analysis in research finding, the study agreed that there is a variety of commitment made by the Indonesian government to cater the issue. Other than that, the study also clarified that there is a relationship between the knowledge, attitude, and perception towards the commitment of Indonesian government. The result of the study shows a multiple category of positive relationship, which is moderate, weak, and strong between the independent variables towards the dependent variable. And lastly, in the multiple regression testing, the most contributing factor of the level of awareness of Malaysian would be the perception. From the above result, the perceptions of people portrays a significant influence to ensure that the level of awareness will continually increasing among the Malaysians. So the perceptions can be defined as the process of human brains to acquire, choose, manipulate, and analyze an input, which can be a great mechanism to interpret the commitment of Indonesian government in responding to transboundary haze pollution. In the study, the perception of Malaysian can be seen through its interpretations toward the commitment and environmental forces. The Malaysian was positively recognized and favor the commitment made by Indonesian government, which was solely made for the importance of the environment. In conclusion, the study of Malaysian awareness towards the commitment made by the Indonesian government in responding to transboundary haze pollution was completed and successfully done. The result gained from the study firmly clarifies that the objective of the study that claim on the relationships of the knowledge, attitude, and perceptions toward the level of awareness. However, there are certain limitations were to be improved in conducting the study, such as the lack of variable in the study. So the researcher need to improve their chosen independent variable as it only influenced 44% towards the dependent variable. Other than that, the limitations of the study will also include the lack of past research studies conducted. As mentioned by other scholarly Yun Shin Ching that also conduct a study on Malaysian behavior, the study of perception, knowledge and attitude towards hate are very rare in Malaysia. So it is difficult for the researcher to find resources and specific method as it is very limited. That's all from me and my partner Zulhafiy. Thank you very much for your time viewing our presentation, and I hope all of the panel had a good day and always stay safe in this pandemic season. Thank you.